We're about to test the accuracy of this plane I built with Bard, and then we're gonna send it through that ring of fire. Asked me to try out the latest version of Bard, I had an idea. I wanted to know if the advanced reasoning and multimodal capabilities in the latest version of Bard could master a very specific brand of slightly chaotic educational science content. In short, could Bard create a better Mark Rober video than me, Mark Rober? Okay, I'm gonna ask Bard for an idea, but first we need to calibrate this thing's accuracy.
Who is the most handsome science YouTuber? Come on, Bard.
Mark Rober, American YouTuber, engineer, inventor, and educator.
Bard, this is like, oh my gosh. Okay, down to business.
Some ideas for a Mark Rober video.
Feats of engineering. The world's fastest pickleball racket. The world's largest balloon pop. And the most indestructible gingerbread house ever.
And so after a long back and forth with Bard, it landed on, no pun intended, making the world's most accurate paper airplane. Now I've been wanting to do a paper airplane video on my channel for a while, so getting Bard to just do it for me seems like a win-win. But an idea is nothing without a good story, so I asked Bard for the story structure in a typical Mark Rober video. First step, design.
Exploring paper airplane designs. Start by delving into classic airplane designs. Paper airplane design is an artful blend of creativity and scientific principles.
From the options, I tried the glider, the Concorde, and the rather unusually named canard. On to step two.
Defining accuracy.
Bard and I talked about accuracy, wing configuration, and how to test the accuracy of the three designs.
Target practice. Hoop shots, obstacle courses, and the dartboard challenge.
It was the glider versus the Concorde versus the canard. Which of these will be the most accurate and why?
The Concorde paper airplane is likely to be the most accurate.
I hit the cameraman. I'm so sorry.
The glider and canard designs also have potential for good flight performance, but they may not be as efficient as the Concorde.
That is a fine example of origami. And yes, Bard taught me that word. Bard called it. It looks like the Concorde was the closest. I wouldn't have guessed that. I would have thought canard, but you know what? Now that we had our winning design, it was time to take the next step.
Optimizing the design. Sure, I can critique the design of your paper airplane.
Okay, so it's saying the wings are too small, the tail is too small, the paper's too light, and that I should use foam board instead.
You need to make it bigger.
Okay, wow. Bard is challenging me, Mark Rober, to make something bigger? It's time to call in the reinforcements.
Make the wings larger, make the tail larger, make the folds sharper. By following these steps, you can improve the stability and control of your airplane.
And now for the final step.
The ultimate accuracy test.
I asked what a visually appealing and engaging test environment would look like for a Mark Rober experiment creating the world's most accurate airplane.
Mark could use
cones to mark the flight, use a fog machine to create a dramatic effect, sparklers to add a touch of sparkle, use small fireworks
to create a grand finale.
Bard is bringing the drama. I love it.
But then I asked Bard to come up with just one more twist. What's the most extreme and eye-catching way to test the accuracy and stability of my airplane for a YouTube video?
Throw it through a ring of fire.
Challenge accepted. Terrible news. Bard, I've got like a 6-foot plane here and I'm trying to fly it through a ring of fire and it kind of stalled out. Do you think it's true that a localized pocket of hot air would lead to lower air pressure that would cause my plane to stall? Yes, it is true that a localized pocket of hot air could lead to lower air pressure, which could cause your plane to stall. Hot air is less dense than cold air. That actually makes sense. So it rises. This rising air creates a region of low pressure below it. That's like exactly what happened there. I think this actually helps.
Keep our pressure at max.
And then we're just gonna like dart right into it as opposed to like the high stall out.
Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Full power, baby, 1300, let's go.
3, 2, 1, hit it.
Oh, that's the one, that's it.
Normally, it takes like a year for me to go from idea to a final build like this. This only took us 3 weeks, thanks to Bard, massive time saver for every step of the process, incredible creative collaborator, right in your pocket. Okay, time to wrap this up. Actually, let's do it this way. What's a good outro for a Mark Rover video? Subscribe for more science experiments and explosions. I'm Mark Rober, and I approve this message. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and a fire extinguisher.